some of the most important seats that are now going to polls are the seats in Uttar Pradesh. Now 16 seats have already we have seen the fight take place out of total 80 seats. Now Uttar Pradesh is the state which sends almost 80 MPs to the Indian Parliament. Out of those 16 seats we saw going to polls in the first and the second phase, and today the 10 seats are going to the polls, and all eyes are on these very crucial 10 seats. The battle actually in the key areas. Yadav family is now contesting from areas like Batayu, Firozabad and Mainpuri. Akhilesh Yadav's wife, Dimple Yadav, now is contesting from the Yadav family bastion. This is a bastion which was pulled brick by brick since the year 1996 by the former Chief Minister of the state, Mulayam Singh Yadav. In 2022, when Mulayam Singh Yadav won by over 5 lakh votes, that was the year when the margin was the highest. After he passed away in the year 2022, Dimple Yadav fought the bipolls and registered a margin of almost 3 lakh votes.
जब तीसरे चरण का वोट पड़ रहा है, ज्यादा से ज्यादा वोट पड़े, यही वोट है जो हमारे और आपके जीवन को बदल सकता है. सोच समझ करके मैं सभी मतदाताओं से अपील करता हूं, तीसरे चरण और अगले चरणों में जहां वोट पड़ेगा, सभी मतदाताएं ज्यादा से ज्यादा वोट डालें. और यही वोट है जो संविधान और लोकतंत्र मजबूत करेगा.
इस बार इंडिया गठबंधन सरकार बनाने वाला है, परिवर्तन का चुनाव है, और इस बार आने वाली सरकार इंडिया गठबंधन की बनने वाली है.
काफ़ी अच्छा चुनाव है. अभी तक 6 तारीख तक माने कल तक तो प्रचार किया गया और हर व्यक्ति तक पहुंचने का प्रयास था. मुझे पूर्णतः विश्वास है कि आज जहां मतदान हो रहा है, सभी समाज के लोग और सभी वर्गों के लोग बदायूं लोकसभा में समाजवादी पार्टी और हमारे लिए वोट कर एक आश्वस्त किया गया है जनता की तरफ से. मुझे पूर्णतः विश्वास है कि शाम को जब चुनाव मतदान खत्म होगा, बड़े अंतर से समाजवादी पार्टी को यहाँ पे वोट मिलने का काम होने जा रहा है.
अखिलेश यादव कह रहे हैं मुश्किलें बढ़ाने वाले हैं अभी यहाँ से.
नहीं, पिछली बार बसपा से गठबंधन होने के बावजूद, मनोवांछित 5 सीटों पर लड़ने के बावजूद, उनकी स्वयं की धर्मपत्नी डिंपल यादव कन्नौज से चुनाव हारी, फिरोजाबाद से अक्षय हारे और धर्मेंद्र बदायूं से हारे, और बहन जी ने उनको 1 लाख से 1.5 लाख वोट दिया था. अब वो 1.5 लाख वोट तो पिछले चुनाव से कम कर दो. देखो, एक मैनपुरी के चुनाव पर आ जाओ कि स्वर्गीय मुलायम सिंह यादव जैसा व्यक्तित्व वाले व्यक्ति केवल 94,418 वोटों से जीते और बहन जी ने उनको 1 लाख वोट दिया, और इस बार उन जैसा व्यक्तित्व नहीं है और बीजेपी से कैबिनेट मंत्री जयवीर सिंह लड़ना है. कहने का तात्पर्य यह है कि यद बसपा का गठबंधन नहीं होता तो मैनपुरी भी वो लोग हार जाते.
माय कॉलीग अमित भारद्वाज इज नाउ जॉइनिंग मी फ्रॉम आगरा सिटी इन द स्टेट ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश. अमित, वी हैव ऑल सीन हाउ उत्तर प्रदेश इज एक्चुअली द स्टेट वेयर मोस्ट ऑफ द पार्टीज कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन, एंड वी हैव सीन द फियर्सेस्ट बैटल टेक प्लेस, बी इट द समाजवादी पार्टी, द कांग्रेस अलायंस ऑन वन साइड, द भारतीय जनता पार्टी ऑन द अदर साइड. We understand the BJP has now set a target that they are now looking at getting more than 75 seats out of the total 80 in the state of Uttar Pradesh.
True, Aishwarya. You know, the BJP seems to be pretty confident about Uttar Pradesh, specifically in the first 3 phases. But there's a plot twist to the third phase as well. The seat that I'm standing in Agra, I had traveled during the campaign phase as well. In fact, I traveled through Braj region of Uttar Pradesh. And if you speak of Agra itself, the fight here is quite interesting. MOS Health, SP Singh Baghel is contesting here for the second time in row. And he's claiming that it's all about the margin in Agra. And the reason behind the confidence of Bharatiya Janata Party in Agra is that they are hoping that the Dalit vote bank will shift to the BSP, while the Muslim vote bank will go towards the Samajwadi Party, meaning that the BJP will have an easy run in Agra, a big margin in Agra. But if you speak of the adjacent seats such as Fatehpur Sikri, I had also travelled to Eta Kasganj Lok Sabha seat as well as Bareilly. Out there, the Thakur community's vote bank is something that is concerning and troubling the Bharatiya Janata Party. Amit, along with that, Samajwadi Party has actually played out a chakravyuh of caste. So we'll have to wait and watch as to how that plays out. Aishwarya.
Right, Amit. My colleague Amit giving us all those details from Agra. My colleague Samarth Srivastava is also joining me from Mainpuri. Samarth, the idea of the Samajwadi Party this election, the 2024 big Lok Sabha election, is to make sure that they consolidate the Yadav votes.
Well, exactly, Aishwarya. The major target for the Samajwadi Party would be to regain the lost constituencies or the gar, what we say, the holds, the places which were the strongholds of the Samajwadi Party, and these includes that Firozabad, Mainpuri, and Itawa, and many other seats. If you talk about Mainpuri, it has been the focal point for the Samajwadi Party since 96. Nobody defeated the Yadav family from here, and this time around, once again, Dimple Yadav is being fielded from Samajwadi Party, while Javier Singh, the UP minister, is against her. So it's going to be very crucial how this contest goes on, because this constituency holds around more than 20% of Yadav vote bank, and there is also a Shakya vote bank, and then comes that Kshatriya vote bank and the Jata right. vote bank, which is around 14 to 20%. So this is right. the concept from here, and we can expect a strong competition right here. Back to you.
Thank you so much for giving us all those details. It is the Yadav vote that the Samajwadi Party is now looking at, and obviously fielding Dimple Yadav from the fortress, the Yadav bastion that is Mainpuri, is speaking about how confident the Samajwadi Party also is in 2024 Lok Sabha elections. That's all the time we have on this bulletin. Just a couple of minutes left. If you have not voted, just go to the voting booth and cast your vote. In the next couple of minutes, the voting will be closing. For more news and updates, keep on watching India Today.